Everybody, it's the Victor time to eat trick here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yosei's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, so that's the reason why we have a little bit of a pause on the like streak counter. But if you've not seen yesterday's video, definitely go check it out. I have no doubt that it will cross 5,000 likes, currently sitting at 4,300 at the time of this recording. Go check it out. It was a fun run. It was fun and then not fun and then fun again. It was one of those seesaw runs. So, and I know I don't mean Jacob and Hee Haw either. Here's a meme of the day. This one brought to you. Incredible meme of the day. Crossover meme fan art all in one by Carlamiz. Hopefully I said that correctly. Title of the thread was The Stitches Mentality and suddenly ... Library of Runa? I don't know. I drew the first things that appeared in my head when Sin mentioned LOR, which I'm loving the series so far and hope it stays in the main channel. Absolutely stunning artwork by Carlamiz. Seriously, go check out the full resolution image on our Sinvicta subreddit because, man... Man, it is great, and especially like the actual tie-in to the lore of Library of Runa is even better. I mean, it's just, it really is awesome. So thank you very much, Carlamiz. This one does not do it justice. Go look at the full resolution panel, and impressive. Thank you all, 240 of y'all who upvoted that one. Let's see what kind of run we got going on today. Well, we're starting with Twisted Pair. That's pretty good. Today is going to be 4 Romeo, 6-1 Delta, Mike, Sierra, Delta. We got the Trinket Smelter, 1 HP, good damage, kind of okay tiers rate, kind of bad range, actually really bad range. But yeah, obviously the biggest concern right now is starting with a 1 HP start. We also have a Hangman card, so if I really wanted to get a little hushy, I could. I'm not going to, but I could. But yeah, I mean, Twisted Pair is going to double, essentially double our shots at a reduced damage rate. It's very, they're both very, very good. It's kind of like having Incubus firing on one side of each of Isaac's shoulder. This is Champion Dingle, so we do have to be careful here. Very happy to at least have Daddy Longlegs help us out. Hopefully he'll keep us safe. Now, Red Dingle is the one that charges an extra time, so you have to be very cautious, especially on 1 HP. It could really take you off guard. He was about to charge there again. We do get a range upgrade, which I'm actually super stoked about. This is one case where I do think that we should go check out the, we can go into the curse room, but it's extremely dangerous and I don't think really worth it. Now, some people, speaking of extremely dangerous scenarios and discussing, you know, risks and whatnot, some people have been bringing up the hypocrisy of me assessing risk, doing risk assessment in Isaac, but then taking Damocles recently. I think that Damocles is worth taking early on, and if you have the Devil Deal precedent. The theory, the logic there is because I want to be able to get myself an extra life to counteract the effects of it. You know, obviously there's an inherent risk with Damocles of it just falling. And we've had the sword fall before. We're not like, we don't have Hutt's luck here. Hutt's, if you know what I'm talking about, Hutt's claims to have never seen the sword actually fall. At least it's not falling on him anyway. But I've had Damocles fall on me like 3 or 4 times over the course of Repentance lifespan so far. But it's not, that's not the same as going down to a half heart and just being dead from anything that touches you. There's a big difference there. And yes, there's a very small chance that it will kill you and stuff. And do I think it's a gamble for sure. But the payoff for Damocles is that if you have the there goes our item. There goes our Devil Deal. I should have dodged this way instead of going back up there. I don't know why. In my mind, I saw the shadow from Daddy Longlegs, thinking that it was one of the leapers that were jumping up in the air, and that caused me to go the opposite direction. What I'm talking about is when the flies are kind of swarming over here. I should not have dodged back up. I should have gone this way. There was an exit over here, but I just explained why I didn't do that. Anyway. But yeah, the logic there being is that if you're good enough to not take damage for a relatively long amount of time after taking Damocles, you should theoretically find some kind of extra life or respawn item, because you remember you're getting double item pedestals, especially if you're going for Devil Deals, and that's the big thing. I'm not going to smelt Apple of Sodom because I actually do want our red hearts, and I'm pretty sure that Apple of Sodom replaces the red hearts with spiders. I think. If you're wondering where the information mod is, by the way, it's I disabled it because we were using the rules mod, and it was absolutely, it was bugging out the rules mod. I mean, it was making it crash every single time. So, it wasn't doing that. It was making. What? Why did we do it? It was any time that a description had come on the screen, like actually like describing like what an item does and that sort of thing. The rules mod was making Isaac spawn stuff every step that he took, and which was not a rule that I had created. So it was very, very weird. Petrified poop being the biggest pickup here so far. Data miner, I don't know about that. We get a soul heart here from Petrified Poop, a lucky penny as well. Wow. This is a one hell of a start here. I am gonna go into the secret room. Two more pennies, I'll happily take that. 27 cents now. So there you see the apple of Sodom. It turns the hearts that you get into attack spiders, which is great. Especially if you have a better than average base damage like we do currently. Oh my goodness, this is the dream scenario. Oh baby.
A card against humanity.
All right. And the entire mosh pit groans. Just think about how many hearts we're going to get and how many spiders we're going to get because of Apple of Sodom. On top of not only on that level, but also like the monetary gain is huge here from having petrified poop. So this is a huge, huge turning point. And I keep saying it over and over again. And every time we get into the scenario, Card Against Humanity is one of the most broken items that you can get in terms of consumables in the game, period. Even if you don't have the petrified poop, you have a very high chance of getting it. And on top of that, I mean, just look at the dividends it's paying out. We get HP, we get money, we get luck upgrades, we get pills. I mean, you get everything that you would ever want or need on a run from one card. From one card, you know? Cardio coin shows up, you know, we don't even need to take it because we're going to be at 99 cents here in a second. Hey, this is great. Yeah, so before we go any further, let's go spend some of this money so we don't cap out here. I mean, Card Against Humanity just changes the scope of an entire run in an instant. Oh wow, you can't actually buy that. Huh. I didn't think it would let me. Unfortunately, we cannot destroy the keeper in the shop. And the only reason why we do that is obviously because we want to boost our Devil Deal chance to get it, but yeah, this is just a rock solid start here. It can win runs. Like, a Card Against Humanity can win a run. Like, we will almost assuredly win this run because of this room right here. And there's basically not any... I would say that there's not very many cards in the game that exist that can say they can win you the run outright. You know, now, obviously, it's early on here, but... I mean... You know, if you think about it, like two of diamonds, like, yeah, two of diamonds doubles your money, but like you have to have money in order to double it. It doesn't give you that much money. Chaos card, yeah, you can kill one boss, you know, but you can't buy like a ton of items with it and stuff like that. It doesn't give you all this HP, you know. The Hierophant card, yeah, you can get two soul hearts, but you know, what's two soul hearts to versus like a whole bunch of them, you know what I mean? I mean, it's just a super, super crazy, insano value that is inherent with the Card Against Humanity. So we leave here with 99 cents, a whole lot of money, lots of spiders. Gurglings aren't even going to be able to touch us. No deal with the devil. No surprise there. And we'll head on down. Good floor. Was that Polyphemus or was that Mom's Eye? Of course, it's going to be Curse of the Blind here. Was that Mom's Eye or was that Polyphemus? That's what everyone wants to know right now. If it's Polyphemus, this is just a GG. Mom's Eye would be less than stellar, but... we even get the Silver Dollar. Silver Dollar is going to give us a shop inside of the womb. So we're going to hold on to the Apple of Sodom here. I like having the passive spider generation. Whenever we see red hearts, and with Petrified Poop already smelted, we're almost guaranteed to get a spider out of each room that has poop in it. There you go, and these random little red hearts as well. Especially, you know what? Thinking about what we just got here with Old Bandage. Old Bandage could also feed us some spiders as well upon taking damage. You get those options here. Devil card gonna boost our damage. Definitely want this bomb here. I think we just go fight the boss now and then we'll double back and go get our item. Rag Mega, more like Rag Dead. Another HP upgrade. Oh no, it does give you the hearts. Okay. Rotten Baby. Ooh, I don't know how we didn't get ding for the spikes there. We get money equals power as well. Wow, man. Talk about everything coming up Millhouse here. If this is Polyphemus, this is going to be one of the best starts that we've seen in a very long time. We got to get through this fine room to do it. The Rotten Baby is going to give us an attack fly every now and then whenever he fires. As long as we're firing, he fires. And he just adds a lot of supplemental damage to your already, you know, good amount of DPS here. And again, if that's Polyphemus in there, brother, we're going to have lots and lots and lots of fun. It is Polyphemus. Oh, baby. That is incredible. So our damage, our spiders that we create with Apple of Sodom and Rotten Baby's flies are going to just be doing gangbusters for us. I mean, it's not even going to be close. And not even that, but like even Twisted Pear, even though they have a reduced amount of damage, I believe it's 33% of our damage, something like that. They're also going to be dealing massive amounts of damage here. I'm gonna go back and we're gonna grab our devil card. We can take Broken Lock, I guess, but Broken Lock's not really gonna help us that much. Actually, you know what? I don't want the devil card. I want the hangman card. So we can use bombs to open up golden chests, but we don't need to do that right now. That was obviously Leech that was in the item room. And Leech, you know, Leech is all right. It's all right. He's a better blood puppy. Right, I said it. /R/hot takes. If I really wanted to optimize here, I wouldn't be picking up any red hearts until after we're done clearing the level. Because obviously they're just going to be wasted on like just little mobs that we can just one shot anyway. So if you, that's a little bit of a min-maxy strategy there. If you have me playing the seed and you find yourself struggling with the bosses, even after getting all this damage, I recommend clearing the floors first of enemies and leaving the red hearts on the ground. And then after that, before you go fight the boss, go back and go pick those up. Apple aside, and we'll give you a whole bunch of spiders that will just destroy the boss. But I don't feel the need to do that. Can I do it? Yeah, sure. Am I going to? No. Far, far, far too lazy to do that. I would if I had to. Let's put it that way. Double key room here for this vault, and we got 10 cents. I mean, it gives us more damage because we've got I equals power. Guppy's head. Oh, my goodness. I don't mind losing the bone heart there. So thank you, Trinket Smelter, for being a huge help to us. But now we have Guppy's head and the aforementioned huge amount of damage that we're going to be doing because of having Polyphemus augmenting our base damage so high. This is going to be brutal. I mean, if Isaac gave up yesterday, just Isaac's got no hope here. Yeah, we use Hangman here to get our keys. I think that's a good use. And Eternal Heart. Good value out of that card. I will take Humbling Bundana. Yeah, you know, just take it all. It's a fire sale. No? Not Fire Festival. That's something completely different. The Fire Festival documentary on Netflix has become my... I associate it with eating, like, dinner. Like, I talked about that before. Like, this was, like, a couple years ago. Do y'all ever, like, when you have a certain food, you just watch a certain show and you don't feel right watching that show without having that certain food? Does anyone else do that? Like, for me, like, I relate certain shows to food because I'm used to eating them, and I only watch that show when I'm eating this particular food. So, for example, Game of Thrones, like, everyone knows I hate season 8. Basically, I hate season 8 more than anything. Oh my gosh, this is just out of control. I won't get into why I hate season 8 right now, but just know that season 8 sucked. Another Curse of the Blind. Unfortunately, we did get conjoined, which is the downside of taking Rotten Baby, but I think that even though at the damage down level, we're still going to be okay. But for like Game of Thrones, I don't... Game of Thrones is like my... I usually only eat like Rudy's Barbecue while watching Game of Thrones. And I feel weird watching it without having like some barbecue. For like it's not an awful documentary, it's just this is an awful situation, but the Fire Festival documentary on Netflix, I relate that with like eating like Italian food, like spaghetti or chicken parm or something like that. There's some other ones that I relate to. I like watching The World's Toughest Prisons on Netflix, and I like eating Panda Express to that. Oh wow, man, Jar of Flies plus this build, oof. That is going to be a big oof. I don't know, maybe I'm just weird. Now we know that inside of the item room was going to be, I think it was the D10, something like that, but we're not going to waste a key on that. We got to go fight Chubb. Was it Chubb? No, it was a horseman. Chubb was last floor. Secret room's below there. I'm not going to go take it though with it being Curse of Blind. There's no way I'm going to risk getting rerolled here. We have the perfect building blocks of a monster run here, with us having Polyphemus. I'm gonna bomb the charge beggar just for the increased chance, greatly increased chance. Super secret room should be right here, and we get another Eternal Heart. Man, We're just feeding these devil deals. It's gonna be war. Yeah, there he goes. We do get our devil deal. Never mind. It's just a dream. And we'll head on to Zaun. I looked away at Discord for 1 second. I didn't see what the item was. But it's not Curse of the Blind, so we'll go find out. We got plenty of keys. A Jar of Flies is going to generate a fly for us every time that we kill an enemy with our tears, not with spiders or flies or familiars. We have to... Isaac has to be the one who kills the enemy in order for us to get a fly in the jar. And that's significant because... You, generally speaking, and I've gone on record to say that I think Jar of Flies is just a better version of Guppy's Head, which it is. Generally speaking, you don't want to cap out on flies, and that's mostly because you want to you can replenish the flies in the jar very quickly, and they're very 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 strong against bosses, early game bosses especially. And especially if you have so much damage, like, they're just going to destroy everything. So it's nice having the... Oh, old bandage paid out there. It's nice having the giant shutdown presence of having so many flies that you just don't even care, like, what you come across, you know? And given that it's so easy to... Should probably actually save these until we're actually going to fight the boss. Given how easy it is to replenish the flies, I think that you should, you know, you should always just use it no matter what. If you get to 20, use it. If you get to 20, use it. Unless if you're about to find the boss and fight said boss, then wait, obviously. Like, you know, if you go over the cap for a little bit, that's fine. It doesn't truly matter, but try to not let your jar of flies cap out that much, because you're basically wasting free damage on other things that you could be getting more flies for. That's just my philosophy on it. And the only scenario that I say don't do that in is if you are about to fight the boss, like we are. Kind of hoping we can go to boss rush here. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna take our fool card, and we're not gonna go into the item room. We're gonna try to make boss rush here. Okay, we gotta hurry. Found soul. Bound Soul, I think. Is that that's the one that fires? Yeah, that's the one that fires. I don't know about that one. We should have enough time to dunk the boss. Yeah, she's gonna, her, as soon as her foot comes down once, she's dead. No deal with the devil. First surprise there, and oh my goodness gracious. I mean, SMB Superfan's great, but Tech Zero with this build is out of control. So Tech Zero is going to put a Tech Laser bridging the gap between shots. And Isaac's Tears can bridge... Or can attach to, can tether to, I guess is the best way to describe it. They can tether to essentially anything, any kind of projectile that originates from Isaac. I'm actually not going to take the stopwatch here. There's no reason for me not to, but I just, I don't know. I just like to listen to the music when it's not slowed down, I guess. Obviously, we're dropping our damage by a whole lot here, but we've made some pretty good gains in, We made some pretty good gains in the money department here. You're here. Also, we still have not found our item room. I'd like to point that out. It's pretty incredible. I mean, when you want more shots, why not get more shots? So we now have even more shots for us to chain to. It did drop our damage significantly. But we can make up that lost damage with money equals power. Plus, we still have Polyphemus, so any damage upgrade that we get is going to be multiplied by a whole lot. And we'll head on down to the next Flizzor. Gonna be Loki, eh? Gonna be there, Loki, eh? Don't you know, bud? I'm convinced that the northern Central American accent dialect is about as Canadian as Americans can get in terms of accents and their delivery and their the way that they their mannerisms, their slang. Like if you listen to Hutt speak, like, he sounds Canadian. You can't convince me otherwise. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot we had silver dollar. It's been so long ago since we smelted it. I should have known who had dealted it. Yeah, you listen to Hutt, and you cannot convince me that he doesn't sound Canadian. I thought Hutt was Canadian the first time I talked to him. I was like, oh man, I went from one Canadian to another. But up there in Minnesota, yeah, old Hutsy, he sounds Canadian. And if you don't think so, you're just wrong. You're just totally wrong. And of course, I mean, there's nothing wrong with being Canadian, you know. I mean, it's a widely recognized accent. You know, they can't say certain words correctly, like, you know, like bagel. Can't say bagel, they can't say plague. They can't say room correctly. Even though as much as I try to get Hutz to say room correctly, he just refuses. I think he does it because, like, he's deliberately obtuse about it. So I told him, I was like, hey, Hutz, why don't you say, he says room. Like, I'm inside my room right now. Like, no, it's room. He's like, no, it's not. It's room. I'm like, okay. Well, we can put up or shut up. Damocles would give us extra items in the hush fight. Let's do it. I'm not gonna go fight Hush now, though. We'll get Hush on the victory lap. I will say it is much, much riskier taking Damocles in this spot than normal. But that risk is counteracted by the fact that we've got not only so much damage, but so much safety in our build here that it's going to be hard for the game to actually deal damage to us. I'm like, hey, Hutt, say room. He's like room. Like, no. Okay. I was like, so I tried to make him think of another way. I was like, okay. Say, like, how do you say roof? Like, you have a roof on your house. He's like, you wouldn't say rough. He's like, no, I'd say roof. I was like, okay, so if you can say roof, then how come you don't say room? He's like, I don't know. Aha, we caught him. But Ryan saying plague is just being, that's just being ignorant now. He's just doing that to get a rise out of people. No one. I've never heard anyone in the history of ever say the word plague when they're talking about plague, except Canadians. It was very weird. If you haven't yet, because there's a lot of people who probably have never seen it before, go watch my How Canadian Are You that me and Ryan did like 4 years ago. I barely just mistimed that bomb, just a hair. Just a hair. Yeah, go watch How Canadian Are You if you want to hear some more Northern Lionisms. Turns out, I'm not very Canadian. But you might be more Canadian than I am. Get perfection. Sure, why not? Sacrificial altar is very tempting. I would hate to lose Twisted Pear, though. Another factor of me taking and using Damocles this late, normally I would not have done that, but another factor of me taking it is because of the fact we had that Emperor card. Because the game is more likely to hit us now than it is at the beginning of a run, especially when we have a run this strong. I'm just also realizing how bad our movement speed is. Hopefully that gets rectified. All right, second seed, Sierra 9, Sierra Juliet, Foxtrot Alpha 9 Alpha. So I think that was Little Loki and Little Hush, or Little Haunt, I mean. I know we're fighting Big Haunt. Are we taking Bloody Lust? And that's it. Blue Husher. Got a Mega Chest here, which could be very good with us having Damocles. Yes, sir. Oh, baby. It begins. Yeah, let's not. Let's just not and say we did. We got the D-Sizzle. Guppy's paw here and a Thame. But I'm gonna. Man, I don't know. I'm actually going to take Safety Scissors over Perfection because Safety Scissors may stop us from getting hit. I would love to go through this entire victory lap without ever taking damage, but that's not likely with given our movement speed. Oh, man. We get more options as well. That's just huge because now with Damocles, we're going to get so many more items out of item rooms. We're going to get so many more items out of bosses as well. We can even get a double deal here, actually, with a golden teleporter. Yeah, we'll take a Tears up and... I'm going to take the HP up for the double deal that we're about to get. We're looking at trying to get Guppy here. Not Guppy, but it is flying and movement speed, which is very important. We'll go back and go take a Thame. Athame. Athame. We'll head on down. Man, oh man, this run is starting to turn into something special here. I like it. Well, that was Dry Baby and Infestation 1. But okay, so there's less than three in here. I think I'm actually gonna re-roll this item room. I'll take sinus or common cold for the poison. So if you don't know, by the way, what Damocles does, what are you doing? And secondly, it will spawn an extra item anytime an item spawns. So an item pedestal spawns. So you get basically double items. The reason why we're getting four items in there is because we just picked up even more options, which doubles the amount of items in an item room. And because we have Damocles now, instead of us getting two, we get four. There's one spawning one, the other one spawning an extra one, so then Damocles also spawns an extra one. And you might be saying, well, then what's the downside of Damocles? Well, if you take damage on a run, once you take your first instance of damage after using Damocles, there is basically, according to a Luke anyway, I cannot speak to how correct this is, how accurate this is, but you have basically a 1% chance every minute that goes by to just die. Go fight the boss now. Gonna be Mons Bro Duncan Stan, and he's already dead. And that would be Guppy. So I'm going to take the movement speed for sure. And shot speed as well for Tech Zero is really good. Okay, so we've got a reroll lock and loaded for the item room. Or the shop. So, but the prevailing logic behind having Damocles is that we're going to be able to get an extra life because of the extra items that we get that spawn in the world and in item rooms and devil deals, etc. It's only natural to assume so. And there you go. It literally just proved my point. So now, if and when Damocles actually falls, if we ever take damage on this run, which is, again, more likely than not, although that chance is going down dramatically with how powerful we're getting, Damocles will just take one of our lives and that's that. And there's basically nothing else to worry about at that point. So this is just a fun, fun run. Very good training run for those of you who've been looking to try to get like better at dodging and whatnot. When you've got Damocles, the threat of Damocles looming over your head, but you've got a very powerful run, it's a good way to train your reflexes, to train your positioning, all that kind of stuff. Because you aim, the stakes are so much higher for you not to get hit. When you have Damocles, you're going to be playing better. You're going to be more in tune with, like I said, positioning and whatnot. So this run will be excellent for people who are trying to learn how to dodge and not take damage. Just don't get hit, forehead. He's a sun card in here. There's some mapping. Oh my goodness. Take Bolitar as well. All right. Well, so Tractor Beam, at first glance, you may be thinking like, wow, that just completely ruined your Tech Zero. Oh, no, 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 my friends. No, no, no. It may have ruined Tech Zero for a couple of our shots. However, oh yeah, we used the Sun Card. However, what we gain is all of our shots that we fire now are basically a multi-shot that will deal all of the damage at once. It front loads all the damage that you have from multiple shots into one big stream of damage. Instead of them spreading out, you're not going to hit with every tier whenever you've got conjoined or, you know, inner eye or whatever. Now all of them are guaranteed to hit. All of them. And that is a huge amount of damage, especially with our base damage, especially when they occasionally chain to where do you have that? Especially when they chain with Tech Zero every now and then. I keep forgetting that we have safety scissors. I'm backing up as if like we're gonna get hit by it. Non-leaf. I don't take non-leaf. Honestly, I don't think we need either one of these, to be honest. I'll take Dark Bum. I guess the quarter two, it's damage. I do want movement speed. And I will take Consolation Prize. So the tier's up. Don't worry, I didn't forget about Dead Bird. Don't worry. People's Champ is safe. Now we're just trying to see, just for funsies, we're trying to see how far we can go until we get hit. We haven't been hit since taking Damocles. That was the Cleaver and Taurus. Leo. That I saw in via Dreamcatcher. Money is capped out at 99, so is our damage. Seeing how Tractor Beam just pulls your shots to wherever you go. So now our shots are less dependent on our aim and more dependent on our positioning and just, you know, and how well we move. Yeah, those are all pretty not great. I mean, Depression is kind of meh. Although we did have that incredible synergy with a Depression and Stitches the other day. Basically where the meme came from. Amps key will make all chests yield more items or consumables, that is. So we can expect to receive more drops out of chests. And you get two keys whenever you buy it, so it's a good pickup. You can't give me a run like this and expect us to lose. There's no way that's happening. We'll take the tiers up. I'm actually going to re-roll. No, let's re-roll this one. Yeah. More movement speed is good for me. And we might be able to find a full charge. Was there one in the store? Yes, there was. The reason why I wanted to re-roll the boss items is just because we have a better chance of getting a stat up. I know that we have four pedestals in here, so. Almond milk, I think, is a huge waste. I know there's some people who really, 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 really love almond milk, and I'm happy for you, but in this spot, I don't think it makes sense. I think that we are making our run worse for no reason at all. Oh man, that was Rotten Tomato. Rotten Tomato with this build. Well, there's our first hit of damage. And surprise, surprise, it's on one of Repentance's favorite new mechanics, the Mimic Chest. The one that hides from you until you get close. And it's very impossible to see the bloodstains whenever you get so much crap on the floor surrounding you. Okay, we're just gonna take nothing but damage here. Big damage ups. Big things happening. It's Spectral Tears as well, which is gonna be fantastic for us. So we're now at a point where Damocles can fall at any time, I think. Now, if Damocles happens to fall when we've got Pins and Needles going, Pins and Needles will stop the death effect. Damocles will still go away, but it will stop you from dying. Our shot speed is just bonkers. Yeah. I mean, Servant's Kiss is great. Star's card gets out of boss rush. I'm pretty sure that this doesn't stack, but we're just going to take it anyway and just to see what happens. Soul of the Well, the keeper's going to spawn a couple of coins here and there. I don't know what I'm looking for. Guess we can go. I suppose we can go. Yeah, Spectrum Tears Lump of Coal is just going to be beautiful. We got butt bombs and birdcage. Shouldn't be picking up money anymore. We don't need any more money. We're maxed out. And we know it. Take it out of pockets and show it and throw it live. This away. That away. Yeah, so we can go into the boss rush here. We're going to get a whole lot of items thanks to Damocles. Like a whole lot of items. A lot of items. No devil deal there. Sissy! How you doing, Sissy? How you doing, Sissy? Oh my god. Sure, why not? Oh boy, things are about to get real spicy. Okay, I thought the tears would kind of like be on the ground, not like be in the air. I don't know how I'm going to aim this, but we've got lots of damage now. They're going over the rocks in front of us. That's actually incredible, and not in a good way. Little sissy. How you doing, sissy? Still not great items coming in from our item room. Fighting beast with this would be a disaster. We would not be able to... I don't think we would actually be able to hit her. I'm not joking. I really don't think that we would be able to hit her at all. That is wild. Now that is interesting that they kind of cascade downward and do this like you can just hit them over and over and over again. That's pretty neat. But I'd rather just still have my regular shots. This whole like arcing 10 miles in the air is not for me. SMB super fan, yeah. And I guess we'll take hemoptysis. Zazel's sneeze. Yeah, there's no way that we'd be able to fight beasts like this. Trust me, I know. I'm actually a little stunned that we haven't found any mapping at all in two runs. HP upgrade. Yeah, we can take Kidney Stone. That's going to make things hectic. We did take Gnawed Leaf, right? Did we reroll Gnawed Leaf? We did take it. Okay, that's what I thought. So if we absolutely had to, I mean, we could just stay still with non-leaf. Oh, man. I tell you what. X-Zero does not like this build with Ipecac and Tractor Beam. X-Zero cannot figure out where to put these shots. I'm kind of loving it, actually. Well, to be fair, To be fair, we have not gotten hit by any enemy since getting damage phase. We've only been hit by daggum mimic chest, and that was it. As far as like taking enemy damage, we have not been hit by an enemy yet. I'm pretty sure we're killing them with like the residual tech zero and not the actual tiers. And the problem here isn't really the tier height, it's the shot speed. That's the problem. There should be a shop on this floor somewhere. If I recall correctly. I think I hit myself there. So kidney stones was causing that cascade of shots that you see in rapid succession. Now finding old Hushy is going to be interesting on this build. But we're due to get a lot of items from him, that's for sure. Oh my god. Reroll that. We get duality. That's going to be pretty pogged. We can guarantee an angel deal.
Two of spades.
And for a card, we will take. Oh, man. Run just got out of control, man. Yeah, see, those mobs are where Spider Mod is very helpful. Because it will betray the location of the invisible mobs. Probably shouldn't have taken that.
The world.
Probably should not have taken the screw, because that just gives us more shot speed and it's already out of control. But at this point, we're just trying to see if the game will crash. We've seen lots of crashes over Isaac Madness Week, that's for sure. So hoping that we get an angel deal here. Definitely need to go back and bomb the keeper. You're seeing the gears turning here. Isaac, you need to calm down, sir. And you already see where I'm going with this. I'm sure you do. All right. We still got other ways to recharge our spacebar item. Oh man, holy light. Thank you. Oh yeah, that's right. The Thame is also causing that to explode. The Thame is explosive, I mean. Okay. All right. We still got other ways to recharge our spacebar item. Modeling clay. Island clay is not terrible, but not what I want. Queen of Hearts.
Queen of Hearts.
Arc Bomb's gonna have a field day with that, hopefully. If you don't know what I'm doing here, I'm using Nun's Habit to recharge the D-Sizzle. We can re-roll the secret room. Binge Eater. Arc Bomb feeding us some HP, and I appreciate that. Or let Dark Bomb pick those up. Sausage is real good for an all stats up. Really is. That's hard to leave behind. But I'm gonna. You Dark Bum. I appreciate you feeding my reroll ability. Has not gone unnoticed. Could go Mega Mush, but we already kind of have Mega Mush in a obscure way. Oh no, we're down to 1 HP. Oh no. Yeah, we take more HP. Oh yeah, we get both of them. Uh-oh. I think we're on our last rerolls here. Well, we could lose all of our lives to get one more full charge on the D-Sizzle. If you really want to, though. It would cost us another 5 lives to do so. See, the problem is that Damocles doesn't go away just because you die, so we can't lose all of our lives. There we go. Now, if you just saw right there, we just dodged Damocles falling. Because we had Gnawed Leaf active. Now, if you're wondering, was that premeditated with me standing there waiting? Yes, that was premeditated. I was waiting for Pins and Needles to go off so we could walk through the curse room without dying. I was not expecting Damocles to fall, but it'll be. I'm going to take Epic Fetus here. I'm curious to see what the interaction is going to be with the multi-shots. Yeah, that seems pretty good. I don't know what sound that was. Bot fly. Get the eraser. Sure, I mean, we can use the eraser. I don't think we can. We're not gonna be able to erase Hush, but we might be able to get his flies. Oh god. We're still firing Ipecac shots. I think it's from Lead Pencil. I don't know where that eraser went. Apparently it didn't hit the flies though. Of damage. Down goes old Hushy. Down goes old Hushy. I don't know what that sound is of whenever we open a golden chest, it's making a weird noise. What's happening is that the flies are killing the enemies before we're getting a chance to actually like kill them with or hit them with the eraser. That's what's happening. Absolutely bonkers run this has been. And if you've been enjoying this run, make sure you click that like button. Leave a comment down below. All that stuff is the best way to support me here on YouTube and your favorite content creators, not just me. But if you want to support someone else as well, not knowing how to do so, I'd like to remind everybody, you know, there's a reason why YouTubers say, you know, like, comment, subscribe, all that kind of good stuff. And because it does matter. The comments matter just as much as the likes do, just as much as the views do. Comments are all about engagement. And just simply leaving a comment, and the reason why you see so many people in the mosh pit who've been around for a while leave so many, you know, comment streaks and whatnot, is because they're trying to, and they're not trying to, but they are directly supporting my channel. I don't know what's going on anymore with these explosions. Oh my god. We've gotten that soul heart over there. I think we'll be okay without it. Infestation 2. Got the mulligan. Beelzebub. We got everything. So thank you for watching, everyone. I really appreciate it. What an absolutely monster run this has been. Again, if you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. And thank you for those of you who go out of your way to do so every single day, every single week, of every single month, of every single year. I really appreciate everyone out there in the mosh pit. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like AD Sanchez, Anthony Bennett, Absabes, and The Revenant. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.